Good morning to all. My name is Manoj Malaw. I am currently working as an assistant professor in St. Martin Engineering College, Department of CSE. Today I am going to explain the topic of cyber security. Cyber security and cyber security attacks. First, what is the meaning of a cyber security? The cyber security means provide security of a data or a network is called as a cyber security. Provide security of a data or a network is called as cyber security. Another definition of cyber security is, cyber security is a technology and process that is designed to protect the network from unauthorized users and attacks. That means the cyber security is the technology and process that is designed to protect the network from unauthorized users and attacks. Here unauthorized users means attackers, and attacks means you have to learn the different types of cyber security attacks. Okay, that means first you have to learn the cyber security attacks. The next topic is attacks. First, what is the meaning of an attack? The attack means any action compromise the security of information is called as attack. Any action compromise the security of information is called as attack. The other definition of attack means gaining the access of the data. By unauthorized user is called as gaining the access of data by unauthorized user is called as attack. Here the word gaining means access the data modifying the data means destroying the data. The attack means gaining the access of data by unauthorized user is called as the attack. That means the unauthorized user can be access the data, modifying the data, destroying the data is called as the attack. That means the third person or unauthorized person access the data, modifying the data, destroying the data, that is called as the attack. These attacks are categorized into two types. The first one is the passive attack and the second one is called as the active attack. That means the attacks are again categorized into two types. The first one is called as the passive attack. The second one is called as active attack. There are two types of attacks. The first one is passive attack. The second one is active attack. First, what is the meaning of a passive attack? The passive attack means in this attack, the data is not being modified. Just access the data by unauthorized user is called as a passive attack. The data is not being modified. Just access the data by unauthorized user is called as the passive attack. That means in this passive attack, no data modifications will be done. No data modifications will be done. The next one is active attack. Active attack means the data will be modified by the unauthorized
user is called as an active attack. That means data modification will be done. In this active attack, modified data can be received by the receiver is called as the active attack. That means sender sent the message, receiver received the message. But sender sent the message, receiver received the another message is called as the active attack. Sender sent the message, receiver received the modified message is called as the active attack. Okay, the passive attack means the data will not be modified, just access the data by third party is called as the passive attack. Active attack means data can be modified by the third party or unauthorized user is called as active attack. Passive attack are again categorized into two types, and the active attacks are again categorized into four types. That means in passive attack using the two techniques or two methods. Passive attacks are can use the two techniques or two methods. The active attacks can use the two techniques, four techniques or four methods. That means the passive attack can using the two methods. That the first one is called as the passive attack using the two methods. Passive attack using the two techniques or two methods. The first one is release of message content. The second one is traffic analysis. Passive attacks are divided into two types, release of message content and traffic analysis. This release of message content means the data, the third party can be just access the data, just listening the data, cannot be modified any data is called as release of message content. This release of message content, the first one release of message content, for example, this is sender, this is receiver, this is third party, the sender sent the message to the receiver, the same message can be accessed by the third party. That means the sender sent the message to receive.